to Sparks, Nevada. I walked into the bus station, there was a payphone in there, it didn't work, but it was nice to look at. Enclosed in vintage ash, nostalgia, nostalgia. Payphone saved my ass so many times when I was young. Saved me from getting mugged over at the corner of Turk and something. Rain was pouring and guys were closing in on me and my New Year's flame. I told her, make a call fast, I got your back. And within a minute, up pulled a taxi. All the funny payphone memories from when I was younger and dumber. I once called my dad from a roadside payphone in Tennessee when I'd fallen in love. I told him, Dad, I've fallen in love and I'm getting married. He humored me and said, how long have you known her? I said, a month. He was chuckling. He said, well, Mark, let me know when you've planned your wedding. A few weeks later, I wasn't with that girl no more. I could hear in my dad's voice on that payphone that I was a smitten, pussy-whipped kid. I didn't know it then, but my dad did, because he was my dad, old and wise, and he knew me better than anyone else did. From there, a short trip to Reno, Nevada. The bus station was closed, but I was so happy to see people of color gathering. They were sitting on benches outside the bus station in downtown Reno. The sun was glaring on the cement, contrasting with the far off Sierra snow capped mountains. I saw three payphones inside, but the cops wouldn't let me in. I said, can I please use a payphone to get a sip of water from the water fountain? They said, hey you, move along. And when I left, I saw a nervous young man crying. A lost soul with nowhere to go. He had just been dropped off at the bus station. People were advising him, telling him about a small welcome in town. Making suggestions. The cops said, everybody beat it, everybody get lost now, move along. As I walked back, I said, hey my friend, look down, there's some cash, grab it quickly. And that he did. Who knows what happened to him? Maybe he found work on a privately owned exotic animal zoo. Maybe he hitchhiked his way from Reno, Nevada to Kalamazoo, Michigan. Maybe he's traveling from bus station to bus station. Maybe he's fine. I heard a woman telling him that she prayed for him. Truckee River. People were picnicking, happy as can be on that April afternoon. I climbed halfway up an overhanging tree where I stood and took a picture of the slow flowing Truckee River. Then from downtown Truckee we drove through Donner's Pass where people ate each other up. And further down the 80 to Emigrant Gap. When we pulled in, there was a long cabin-like structure. She parked while I stepped outside and took a peek and saw people watching a strange film. The portion I saw was a close-up of a woman's skin. A kind man stepped outside and said, how can I help you, sir? I said, we saw a sign for a payphone at the exit. He said, that payphone's been gone a long time. I said, what's going on in there? He said, we're showing a film because of our absent lecturer. I said, is he absent because of certain guidelines? And he said, yeah, we're showing a film instead. Maybe drop by another time. I said, what is this place anyhow? He said, it's a rehabilitation center. 13-month program ranging from people with drug and alcohol problems and also for suffering with depression. What's another part interests me? Now you've got my attention. He told me the website when I left. He said, God bless you and safe travels, man. I said, what did you just say? He said, yeah, that's right. Royal Christian Base Program for 18 years old and over. I said, that's a very large age span. He said, well, 18 is a dog. I said, I see, just like prisons, when you're 18, you share the same structure as senior citizens. I said, well, who knows? One day, they could have counted me in. I'm intrigued by the part about depression. Well, I'm not interested in the part about your religion. Plus, it's too close to the Donner Party happened. Plus, this place kind of reminds me of the Shining. He said, well, bear in mind you, I didn't come to you, you came to me. You knocked on my door, I didn't knock on yours. And I got in the car and I asked Caroline, does this place strike you as the kind of place that 13 months of time would be healing? Does it strike you as sort of culty, and that kind of time in the snowbound place could mess with your mind? Up in cold fast and ordered pizza, and we were mesmerized by a young lady twirling pizza dough, and two lovebirds behind the counter were giggling and flirting while working away on their many pizza orders to go. Young love is so beautiful and painful and mysterious, wondering where will it go? We should go off to college and meet somebody new and break his heart while he's back in Colfax sprinkling cheese on pizza dough. They have 5 children who live happily ever after in Colfax. Who knows? Will they leave town in an old Honda Civic and get married somewhere along the Pacific and live in a house in Mendocino with a yard full of abalone shells and get divorced? She's chasing him down for child support and alimony. Well, young love is so beautiful and painful and mysterious. Where will it go? Young love is so beautiful and painful and mysterious. Where will it go? Young love is so beautiful and painful and mysterious. Where will it go? Young love is so beautiful and painful and mysterious. Where will it go? I said, thank you, Caroline, for this road trip to Sparks and Reno. It was nice to go the American and Truckee rivers and skip stones and see old payphones and drive along 6-foot high mounds of snow.